Thank you, Senator Boyce. Senator Lyons.
Thank you, Madam Acting Deputy President. I rise today to talk about a number of issues that come out of the Abbott government's harsh and cruel budget. And it's quite interesting in this place that the government doesn't seem to think that we're asking enough questions during question time or that we're not talking about the budget. But what Labor senators and MPs have been doing is going out into the community and talking to those many hundreds and thousands of groups that are directly affected by this harsh, cruel budget. And when you look across the youth area, there's not one program, not one organisation who works with youth in our country that hasn't been really badly affected by this harsh, cruel budget that the Abbott government keeps trying to describe as fair but doesn't seem to have many takers on that front. And so I want to start with a program called Youth Connections. And it does seem that the government, and perhaps Senator Ryan in particular, don't really understand what Youth Connections does. But it's a program that's got a huge success rate, a really positive success rate, and not just in engaging young people, but in keeping young people in employment and education. And what Youth Connections do is that they go out and work with youth and support youth who are disaffected. So youth who aren't in education or youth who are not in employment. And the two programs I want to talk about in particular are two in Western Australia, one out in Midland and one in the northern suburbs of Perth. And the one in Midland is quite unique because Midland is quite a built-up community, but large parts of the Swan Valley are also what you would describe as rural. And even within that catchment area of the Swan Valley, there's places which are remote simply because they lack adequate public transport and so on. And this Youth Connection service, which runs and sponsored out of the RISE and another amazing organisation in Western Australia, who sponsor Youth Connections, has really got a fabulous success rate. And I would urge Senator Ryan in particular, or perhaps other West Australian senators, to have a look at the Youth Connections program at Midland and see for themselves exactly what they are chopping off, what access they are denying to the young people that are currently being assisted in that Midland area. So this program works with children as young as 11. So imagine already a child at 11 who's been so turned off by school that they're not in school and they're roaming the streets. And so by chopping the Youth Connections program, the Abbott government is leaving those children with nothing. Certainly the schools they attend, the primary schools in the Swan Valley and Midland area, certainly don't have the resources to go and engage with those children and get them back into school. And even if those areas had truancy officers, that isn't going to cut the mustard, because truancy officers can force children to school, there's no doubt about that. But whether children stay at school and engaged in learning is a whole different area, and one the Abbott government seems to be completely denying. So what Youth Connections has done in that area is re-engage those very young children with school. And we know, all of us know, that in order for children and young adults to be successful, they have to have a basic education. And so being able to engage with those young people at such a young age and get them back into school and keep them in school is a very worthy project, and not a project, certainly not a project by any stretch of the imagination, which should be chopped. So at one level it does that. The other area that Youth Connections has been very successful in is engaging teenagers who've either fallen out of education, become disillusioned with the school system, or haven't been able to get into a job. So it's been really, really successful in engaging with those young people. And they're not lazy. Let's just get away from this image that we have to force students to go out and earn or learn. Some of the young people that I met in that program were simply the result of dysfunctional families. I met an amazing young woman who's part of the Youth Connections at Midland, who had really significant mental health issues. So she was not able to engage with employment. Through no fault of her own, she'd come up in a very difficult family circumstance. And what Youth Connections had been able to do with her very, very successfully was to engage her very early on with some mental health programs. And so when we chop Youth Connections, let's be very clear that we are just simply denying young people that opportunity to engage in an appropriate way. Forcing that young woman into employment, or indeed to force her into a situation where she had no money, would not have assisted her, would not have assisted her in one single way. But Youth Connections, who were able to work with her, to support her, to get her help where she needed it and support with the issues that she had, has enabled that young woman, who's a shining star. She's a true example of how successful these programs can be. It's enabled her to go on and to be successfully employed. She's a very articulate young woman. But without that support from Youth Connections, she says herself she has no idea where she would be. And this is not an expensive program. It isn't. It's actually, in terms of value for money, it's right there. It ticks all of those boxes. And again, the Abbott government's earn or learn kind of approach with a young woman like the one I met out at Midland is not going to work. She was not able to be successfully employed because she had a whole lot of issues. And then so the opposite of that would be that she'd be punished and left with no income, whereas Youth Connections has been able to work with her over a short time period to get her the help and support that she needed, and she's now a successful young woman. But these are, whilst I'm giving you random examples, the runs are on the board in terms of the Youth Connections program. It's got something like an 80% success rate across this country. 80% success rate. And we haven't seen that anywhere else. And it's not just the one approach that works with young people and indeed with anyone. We have to have a variety of approaches. And what the Abbott government is doing with this harsh and cruel budget is chopping off those chances. And this young woman that I spoke to was despairing about what would happen to other young people that she knows who are in difficult circumstances. And indeed, she talked about her own brother who needed additional support. And she was very, very worried about what would happen to him come the end of the Youth Connections project. I also met Mission Australia, who also work with youth who've got a raft of issues, significant issues. And I met three young people there. One young woman, again, incredibly bright and articulate, but had been a drug user. And at that point, she had been 1 week free of drugs. And she'd been part of a mission project before, but had fallen back into using drugs. So this was her second try. And what Mission told us is it is quite common for young people to not succeed the first time in giving up alcohol or drugs, but being able to succeed a second or third time. And Mission takes a non-judgmental approach, and the young people are welcome back in. And I had every confidence that that young woman was going to be able to succeed this second time round. But again, Mission were telling us some of the programs that they're operating where they support young people in whatever way they need their support to enable them to either go back into education or to find them jobs or indeed accommodation. All of that's at risk. And these three young people we met, one of them had just been successful in picking up employment, a young man who'd previously been unemployed and under the Abbott government's harsh, cruel budget regime would just be left without any income. He'd picked up employment. He was very proud of himself, and as part of that employment, he was being given the opportunity to study at TAFE and to pick up a certificate. And the third young man I met had, like the young woman, had issues in his life to do with substance abuse, had turned himself around again with the very strong support of Mission Australia, and was looking forward to studying at TAFE, and indeed was going to be taking up a place at FOYA. Now, FOYA is a youth accommodation service on Oxford Street in Leederville, made possible by the funds available under the National Partnership Agreement on Homelessness. So again, a young man, given an opportunity, was going to be going to pick up accommodation at FOYA. Again, not just given a room, but given the support that he needed. And all of that is now up at risk because of the government's absolute dogged approach. It's one. This is the one way we're going to use for youth. It's earn or learn, or you'll be without any income. Of the seven young people that I saw a couple of weeks ago who don't really fit particularly well any of the government's criteria, all of them would have been much worse off under the government's new Earn and Learn program, because they needed that support, and that support is now being ripped away from them. The other service that was there in the morning that I met with people was a service that operates in the northern suburbs of Perth called Youth Futures. And it's had an amazing success with young people, again through Youth Connections funding. Something like almost 700 young people have gone through their service. Very high success rate, something up around the 80% success rate. And all of that will be chopped come the end of this year, because the Abbott government, with its harsh and cruel budget, has seen fit not to give the Youth Connections program any more funding. As I said earlier, it's not an expensive program. It's certainly not layered with red tape, and it is a very successful program. And it's seemingly the hallmark of the Abbott government is not to look at facts and figures. It's pure ideology. Oh, that was a Labor program. Doesn't matter if it was successful or not. We have to chop it down because it was Labor's idea. Therefore, it's not anything we can agree to. That's the kind of summation that I've come to when I look at programs like Youth Connections, solid track record, doing amazing work with young people in our community who are falling through the cracks and will continue to fall through the cracks. But nevertheless, chopped, cut up, discarded, and putting nothing in its place. Job Services Australia cannot take the place of Youth Connections. It simply doesn't have the staff, it doesn't have the reach, it doesn't have the connections. One of the things that the Midland Youth Connections Service does is going to shopping centres and talk to young people who congregate in there. And we've all seen them when we go into shopping centres. Young people are disconnected, hanging around in there. Well, they've been able to go in and successfully engage with those young people and create that connection. There is no way, there's no way Job Services Australia can do that. It just can't. It's a one-size-fits-all. And the Abbott government's chopping of Youth Connections is again an example of the one-size-fits-all. And I don't know if Senator Ryan was really suggesting that somehow the trade tools allowance was replacing Youth Connections. If he was, he's sadly mistaken. The two programs are completely unrelated. The tools program means that you're in work and you need some support. Whether I agree with it or not, that seems to me the essence of that program, whereas Youth Connections is engaging with disengaged young people, young people who've fallen out of school, who've fallen out of work, who need that additional support in whatever form. Sometimes it's accommodation, sometimes it's health issues. It can be a range of issues. That's what Youth Connections does. It's successful. Now, I would urge the government to re-look at Youth Connections and not simply just say we're going to cut that because that was a Labor program and we're ideologically opposed to that. This is about the future of young Australians that the Abbott government is simply throwing on the scrap heap. Throwing on the scrap heap. And those young people I spoke to are very concerned about their own futures post-December 31, when Youth Connections will disappear. Thank you, Mr. Acting Deputy President.
Senator Di Natale.